Hello there. Thanks for checking out this Synapse video demonstration. In this demo, I'll be showing you the runtime window that's displayed during an experiment. I've already created a spike sorting experiment, so let's start with preview mode. This will allow me to make any adjustments needed and define the sort parameters before collecting data. This is the runtime window and the main plot view. I'll scale the plot so you can see the data as it comes in. This tab includes a plot for each data element that Synapse is recording, and each plot is automatically configured according to the type of data. For example, snippets, streamed waveforms, or epoch events. You can rearrange the display by right-clicking or double-clicking specific areas. I can right-click here to change the order of the subplots. I can double-click here to open the data monitor settings. Here, I can increase the time span to see more data per screen, or reduce it to see more detail in less time. Double-clicking the axis of a subplot opens its display options. I can change the plot type, or the number of channels displayed. The runtime window also includes a tab for each gizmo-generated runtime control. One tab includes the filter options for the LFPs we'll be recording. Everything related to spike sorting is bundled into a single gizmo, and all of the related controls are on this gizmos tab. This tab has the threshold and clustering tools and configuration options. I can change some things on the fly without changing the experiment defaults. Next, let's switch tabs for a moment. Here, we can see that not every tab needs a full window. Whenever I want or need to, I can rearrange the tabs, like you might with applications on your desktop. Floating a tab allows me to resize it, or drag it to another monitor. My favorite way to arrange the tabs is to split up the window area. You can arrange things to make it easier for you to work. The window layout is specific to the user. If you have multiple users in your lab, users can have their own layouts for each experiment. That means you can have it your way. Let's switch to a different user now. You can see here that Chris has a saved layout of his own. If my desktop gets out of hand, I can click Reset Layout to get back the default the next time I run this experiment. But I want to show you that my layout is still saved for me. My layout is just how I left it. I'm going to go ahead and let Synapse automatically cluster the data. The state of all experiment variables, including filter settings, threshold values, and cluster definitions, are saved in Synapse's relational database during each recording session. The Synapse database logs any changes to these settings. This is called persistence. When I have the sorting parameters set up how I like, I can switch to record mode. And those same parameters are automatically loaded. The persistence menu on the left tells Synapse which saved state to apply when I change modes. By default, Synapse always goes back to best, which is, well, the best choice in most cases. It's the ending state from the last run of this subject and experiment combination. If I switch subjects, that subject's best persistence state is loaded. If I use a new experiment with this subject, but want to use the same sorting parameters, I can choose last persistence before I start my recording, and regardless of subject and experiment, the previous persistence is loaded. I can also go back in time to any state from any previous recording. Suppose my lab tech is fumbling around and changes the filter settings. And I notice something off when I'm analyzing the data. I can open the history dialog to see the previous recordings. The history dialog is useful for a lot of things. You can filter the recordings by time, user, subject and experiment. As I click the recordings, a log of all the changes made during the recording are displayed in the bottom pane. Aha! I see the filter settings were changed here. If I want to, I can go back to the starting state of that recording. Notice my persistence switched to user. Now when I go into record mode, the previous filter settings have been restored. Notice that every time I choose a persistence option other than best, Synapse resets the persistence to best after the run is over. Suppose I want to use the default experiment parameters for the next recording. I would choose fresh. To use it every time, I could engage the lock icon. Persistence doesn't just apply to spike sorting and filtering. Every Synapse gizmo that has a runtime interface uses the persistence engine. The more you become comfortable with the persistence features, the more you will realize how helpful they are, and how much you already rely on them. That's all for this lesson. If you haven't already tried our other videos, be sure to check them out. Bye for now.